Good morning, students. This is IK Mishra. Again, came here with taking a video for class 8. Chapter 3, x square and square root. In previous videos, I discussed how you will find squares of any number. Now, today, I am going to discuss about a square root. First of all, know a square root. Square root means the square root of a number x. Suppose we have to find a square root of x. That means square root of a number x is that number which when multiplied by itself gives x as product. Square root of any number means, suppose I write here a square number 9 and we have to find square root. Square root. When we multiply 3 into 3 equal to 9. That means it is multiplied 3 into 3 gives 9. Hence square root of 9 is equal to 3. Here, students always notice the symbol that is used for denote square root or denote square root by the symbol this. Suppose we have to find square root of x, it will be written as root x. This is the symbol used for root x, square root. And square root we have to find, suppose we have to find square root of 16, it will be written as this. And we have to find square root, we will use two rules. In the first rule and in this video we will discuss only first rule by prime factorization method. In prime factorization method, how will you find the square root of any number? Suppose we have to find the square root of this number by prime factorization method. That means we have to find square root by prime factorization method. We have to find square root by prime factorization method. By prime factorization method, you have to first of all find prime factors. Suppose you have to find square root of a number 576. Find, your question is, square root of 576. That means it will be denoted as under root, this symbol, and 576. And for finding it, first of all, factorize it. 576. Factorize 576. First of all, divide it 2 by 2. 2, 8, 8. Here, 2 times 1, 4, 4. Again, 2, 7, 2. Again, 2, 3, 6. Again, 2, 2, here, 9, here, 3 and 3. here if 576 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. That means we have to find square root. For square root 576 is equal to under root, here it will be written 2 square into 2 square into 2 square into 3 square. Here by the square, which factors have a square, that will be written 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. That means 2 into 2 into 3 equal to 24. It will be the square root. Hence, the square root of 576 equal to 24. When you multiply 24 by 24, then you will get 576. Students, here we have to solve some questions. First, find the square root of 2025. For finding the square by prime factorization method, first of all, do prime factorize of 2025. Do prime factorization. First of all, divide it by, first of all, say 5, 2, 7, 2, 9. It is divisible by 3. So, divide it by 3. 3, 6, 18. And 3, 7, 21. And 5 times. Again, divide it by 3. 3, 2, 6. 3, 2, 6. And 5 times. Again, it will not. Again, it also be divisible by 3. Again, divide by 3. 7 times. And 5 times. Again, also it is divisible by 3. 2 times and 5 times. Again, it will be divisible by 5, 5. So, it's prime factorization. So, we have to find square root of 2025. It will be written as under root. Its pair be 3 square into 3 square into 5 square. By the square, square root be cancelled. So, it will be written 3 into 3 into 5. That means its square root is 45. Friends, clear? So, square root of this number is equal to 45. Again, your next question is, find the smallest number by which 396 multiply must be multiplied so that the product becomes a perfect square. For this, you have to also find the prime factorization of this. First of all, find the prime factorization 396. Divided by 2, 1 times and 9 times and 8 times. 2, 9 times and again 9 times. Here, 3 divided by 33. Again, 8 divided by 3, here 11. When you write it 396 equal to 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 11. Observe here, all these two factors have pair, but it has no pair. If 11 we multiplied this number, then the result be a perfect square. So, required number, be 11. And when we multiply it by 11, if 396 is multiplied by 11, then we get 396 and 396, 6, 5, 3 and 4, get 4, 3, 5, 6. It is a perfect square number. Friends, you can solve this type of question easily. Now we have to solve another example, another question. Find the smallest number by which 2925 must be divided to obtain a perfect square, and also find the square root of the perfect square so obtained. That means, first of all, we have to find the number by which the given number be divided to get a perfect square number. So first of all, do prime factorization of this number. Prime factorization of this number 2925. Here you check 5 to 7, 7 to 9, 9, 18. Here sum is 18, that means it will be divisible by 3. First of all, divide it by 3, 9, 27 by 2, remainder 2, and 7 and 5. After that, 3, 3, 3 is 9, 3, 2 is 6, and 3, 5 is 15. After that, it will not be divisible by 3. 5, 2, 7, 3, 10. That means it will be divisible by 5. 5, 6 is 30, and 5. After that, 5, 13. That means here 2925 is equal to 3 × 3 × 5 × 5 × 13. Here you observe two factors having pair of itself, and one is 13. If it will not here, then this number be a perfect square. So here our required number, that means the smallest number by which 2925 must be divided. So required number is equal to 13, and when you divide it, the given number, by 13, new number by dividing 2925 by 13, we get 3 × 3 × 5 × 5. So its value is equal to 5 × 5 = 25, and 9 = 225. So this number is 225, new number, and its square root we have to find again, the square root of this number. So square root of 225 is equal to, it will be written 3² × 5², and that means its square root is equal to 3 × 5 = 15. So square root of the number is 15. So it's another part. Also find the square root of the perfect square so obtained is 15, and required number by which this number is divided to get a perfect square is 13. Very important. Another question is, find the least square number which is exactly divisible by each of the numbers 6, 9, 15 and 20. That means you have to find a number, perfect square number, that will be divisible by 6, 9, 15 and 20. For finding that number, first of all, you have to find the prime factorization. That means you have to find LCM of this number. Find LCM of LCM of 6, 9, 15 and 20. For find LCM, 6, 9, 15 and 20. Divide it by 2, 3, 9, 15 and 10. Here, divide it by 3, 1, 3, 5 and 10. After that, all divide by 5, 1, 3, 1 and 2. After that, its LCM is 2 into 3 into 5 into 3 into 2. So its LCM is 2 into 3, 6, 30 and 30, 6, 180, 36, 30 and 6 multiplied, 180. Its LCM is 180. So its answer will be a perfect square number, that means square of 180. So required number is equal to 180 square. And when you find the square of this number is equal to 28900. This is the required number. So students, I think all the important questions of exercise 3D is completed, and I give you homework to complete the exercise 3D of book R.S. Agrawal. I think you can completely solve all these questions. If any problem, then contact me. I will solve your problems. That's all. Thank you.